You can configure it, but it's basically high-end i7 processor, lots of RAM, nice keyboard. In fact, notice, kind of an expansive keyboard. At first I thought, what is this, for the Excel junkie? It has a numeric keypad, but then I realized, oh no, that's gamers want those,
yeah,
right? Because many PC games use those gamepads. This is, it's got a NVIDIA GeForce GTX 630 in here, fairly high-end video card. It's big, it's heavy, 15.6-inch screen. Now the touch version has 1080p. They do make a version of this with a UHD screen. But I have to say, even with 1080p, I found it hard to read this. I had to go into the Windows settings and make the fonts a little bit bigger, because some of the touch points are a little hard to see. And just as you would expect with a laptop that's about media, it's got pretty good sounding speakers.
Really good. That sounds great.
The bass is good. It's ported bass on the bottom. It's Dolby, or doubly, as they say. These are JBL speakers. And I think, you know, I mean, look, it's not going to, you can't have a party, but if you're sitting and playing a game or watching a movie, it sounds pretty good for laptop speakers. There's got to be a way to stop.
That's the modern UI. There we go.
There's got to be a way to stop that. It is Windows 8.1, and it has some Lenovo. has some Lenovo stuff on it, as you'll see, including, I'm sad to say, McAfee built in, and McAfee has been popping up. In fact, it says, you only have one more day. Come on, you want to update your subscription? Just today it started popping up and saying that. But, of course, you can uninstall anything extra on here. It's just a shame that the companies still feel like they have to lard this stuff up with trialware.
Yeah. Who is this built for?
I'm thinking it's a home user. It's what we call a desktop replacement. There's a couple of cons, though, on this, because, for instance, something this size and this weight, and it's fairly heavy, I think ought to have an optical disc.
Yes.
You don't have a Blu-ray player. This is a screen meant for Blu-rays, and it really is a beautiful screen, but no optical disc on this. It does have two USB 3 ports, one USB 2 port, has HDMI. One thing I do like, and maybe this is for LAN parties, it has Ethernet. It's rare that you can get an Ethernet, physical Ethernet jack on a laptop these days. So it's kind of an interesting mix. Battery life, not great. Lenovo rates it at 4 hours. I was getting 345, 3.5.
No.
Yeah, very low. Especially for something that's heavy enough that you could, you know,
you could put a huge
battery in it. Unlike that HP that you saw, there's no easy way to remove this back. These are screws all the way around. I suppose you could get in there, but Lenovo doesn't expect you to. They're not, you know, they're not really interested in doing that. Let's talk about pros and cons on this thing. On the pros, it does have a good keyboard. On the cons, it doesn't have the typical ThinkPad track touch thing. It's got a trackpad, and not a very good trackpad. Notice, not only is it off center a little bit, that's thanks to the numeric keypad, but it has a left and right side. I shouldn't have eaten those pop-pops.
Yeah, that's a horrible design, especially since the
I clicked the wrong side
each time. It's so Lenovo specific.
Yeah.
They love that.
This is the anti-ThinkPad. This is Lenovo saying, wait a minute, we can do design, see the red trims, the red touches. We can make something sounds good. This is for a home user. Obviously. It is fast, and it's a beautiful screen. I like the screen. Touch was a little sluggish, and I don't know whether to log in here. I don't know whether to blame Windows 8 on this or whether to blame the touch, but I was frequently doing this more than once, trying to, you know, get the various gestures to work, coming in from the edge and so forth. And it could be that the screen wasn't super responsive, but, you know, I often blame Windows 8.1. I'm just not a big fan of Windows 8. Friends don't let friends buy Windows, my friends. So I have to give that a negative. Price is a little high, too. At $1,200 starting point, you could get there are many good choices, including, I should point out, a MacBook Pro you could get in that price point. And you might be a little bit happier with the operating system on that. Keys do light up. So pros, good keyboard, good sound, good screen. The physical attributes of this are nice. On the cons, an okay trackpad, but I don't like the way that it's divided up. It's very confusing. Notice, by the way, I'm doing gestures every time I touch the trackpad. That drives me nuts. That's Windows 8, my friends. The hardware, though, is very good on this. The downsides, very poor battery life, a little bit pricey, and a lack of optical drive really seems to be a negative to me. On the other hand, I can't say this is a do not buy. It's a strong contender in a fairly crowded market. You got to like this nice metallic touch. Top and so forth. I'm going to say it's a try. It may not be the perfect computer for you. It certainly isn't the right computer for somebody who wants a business-style ThinkPad. This ain't a ThinkPad. This is a home machine, a desktop replacement, most likely designed for the gamer on the road. That's the Lenovo Y50 Touch. I don't like to do try, but I'm going to give this one.
You can find out more about this fantastic offer by clicking the link in the description.